Good evening, folks. Welcome to tonight's game. Anticipation, we're underway.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. Try to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Got a nice screen. Working it around the perimeter. He's got a nice shot fake. Down inside. Oh, clinical drop step.
I tell you, clinic 101 on how to utilize the drop step from the low post.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. And up.
He can't get the J to go despite running off the nice screen.
They go into the low block. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle too, but he goes up and under. He seals off the defensive player.
Now trying to feed the low block for the bucket. Perfectly executed. Top of the circle, off the rim and no good. Tries for two. Defensively down on the low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
Trying to feed the low block. That spin move's not going to work against the defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Number 33 gets the pass. And he missed. Number one gets the ball. Number one, pump fakes. Goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
What a terrific job on the defense to beat him in the spot, Mr. Nessler.
With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He shoots from long range. Comes up short. Tries the turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Number one is emotionally pumped up.
Well, he's had some success, and he feels good. This kid's on an emotional high right now.
There's a slam. Had a momentary look from three-point land for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
How can you not love this game and the hoopla and fanfare that goes along with it?
Hey, pandemonium is in full effect.
Moving it around the perimeter. This young man means so much to them and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
First half update again. Dick Vitale, in your opinion, our focus player, what do you think he's doing so far?
I'll tell you one thing, Brad, you're exactly right. And he has really excelled in every category, but everybody else is just watching.
He stays in control until they regroup the offense. The skip pass is picked off. Number two takes the pass. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position of spreading his body and getting the ball.
I think a defensive stop on this possession, Dick, will have this crowd just roaring. He pump fakes. Dickie's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Number 50 with the ball. And now with a power move on the inside.
Did a great job protecting the basketball, seals the defense off, and explodes to the basket. What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
It around the perimeter in the paint. They work it back to the outside. Fake. Leans in. Perfectly executed.
Let's see if it looks as good on the replay.
Gave it up. He does the sweet fake shot. He tries a jump hook.
I tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great we've got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
He went for the steal in the post and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled.
It looks as though the students are all wound up and ready to agitate the opposition.
The student body looks like they're having some fun out there.
Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. On the outside, unloads, knocks it down. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Jumps into the defender. Basket falls despite the contact. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, the coaching staff knew this would be a key heading into tonight's matchup. This is something they stressed during pregame, and it's something they're talking about on the benches right now. The message, get the ball inside. Guys, they're doing that.
All right, thanks, Aaron.
I'll tell you one thing, you better be able to establish post play because that gives you inside-outside action.
Here's a drop step, the low block.
Very key is to get good post position, and he does, and then he drops the step a little up.
Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first, initially, he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays it where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebounding position, a good block out, and that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
Let's see if they go two for one here, Dick.
Dump it inside.
The shooting guard takes the feed. It's good. On the inside. That's one of them. He takes the hard hack in the air, but he lays the ball in.
That's what you take for the team, Brad.
Okay, Dick, some people were predicting this. The players are starting to taunt one another. He goes to the line for the first time. He sinks it. Shot clock is dead.
Oh, what a strip, Brad. The athleticism in some of these kids, Brad, I'll tell you, it's incredible.
He shoots from half court, way off target. Dick, we've got a close one here tonight, my friend. Give us your highlight of the night so far.
This trifecta was the key for me, Brad. It opened up the game in the first half. It'll be interesting to see if they can keep up the outside shooting in the second.
The teams are just about ready to start the second half, Dick. Let's see how this one unfolds. Dick started the second half, and we take a look at our focus player, and he's going to have to be the man to come through.
I think he's got to attack the basket a lot more. I think he's got to get opportunities to go to the free throw line, and that'll come if he becomes aggressive.
They go inside, and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Looking for a good shot. Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
Goes up for two. There was no doubt about that one. This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. It up and in. Number two is called for the foul. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
Working it around the perimeter. With a fadeaway jumper, look at that follow through.
I tell you, he uses the ball really well, too. In terms of putting it to the deck, turns, spins. He's got every move in the book.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And he knocks it down. Now they work it around the perimeter. Puts up the tray. He's good for another score.
Hands in his face. Any time now, boys?
There's a double team waiting there. Unloads a three. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Brad, he's not getting any help out there. It's basically one against five. Not good odds.
From the top of the circle, Dickey's in a serious rhythm.
Hey, that's because he's getting the ball in rhythm, Brad. Very important.
Tries for two. They still don't score. Fakes it. With the fake. Jump hook from the low block. Doesn't go.
Great play to take that to the basket.
For two. Can't get the shot to go.
Look at that spacing.
Pull up jumper from way out. Off the rim and no good. Trying to draw the foul. Drops the bucket despite the harm. On the outside, he attempts the three. He bangs it in for another score.
And the hits just keep coming on, baby.
Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got him in the face-up position in the post.
Launches the three. Way off target. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Good fake. Trying to draw some contact. He puts it in with contact and all. The fake.
Double team now, bad angle.
Three. You betcha.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Off the rim and no good. Goes up for two. Gave it up. Time to pick up the defense here now. They work the perimeter. Looks at the three.
Wow, used the screen perfectly, but the shot didn't go.
This place will be in complete chaos if this defense can get a stop right here.
Very soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
With that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. He'll visit the charity stripe. He hits it. Both free throws go. Entry pass in the paint. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
And he missed Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Guys, he seemed very focused from the beginning. His game face was on, and he understands it's his time to perform. Let's send it back to you.
He goes for three. Goes. This young guy is a crowd favorite, Dick.
He's very popular, Brad. He has done some great things on the court, and the people really appreciate him for it. Pressure that basketball.
And he scores despite the hack. This one is shaping up to be a barn burner, Dick.
You've got to love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
They've got a player spotting up on the three. He goes with a jump hook. He gets another shot off and in.
Hey, this show's about to start, Brad.
Jumped in front to take it away. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I'll tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
Dumps it in.
There's the trap.
He gets it to fall. 2-point game. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
There's a look at the timeout situation.
Hey, some people like to call it game management, Brad. Knowing when to use timeouts is an art. Also, team fouls. Defending without fouling is always important. Nice fake.
Here's a double team. Strips the ball. This defense isn't yielding an inch.
Hey, the offense looks very timid, Brad.
Work it inside, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They push it up on the break. He makes the shot. We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game. Do you think they switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. The small forward with the ball. He hits it. Working it around the perimeter. Takes the pass in the paint. For two.
Take a look right here. Up and inside.
From top of the circle.
Better foul quick.
That's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick?
Now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to be able to get to that winner's circle.
another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession or timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
As we take a look here at our backcourt production.
Hey, Brad, I'll tell you one thing. Productivity from the backcourt is a must. You must initiate the offense, distribute the ball, and score. These are all things that you rely on your backcourt to do.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. This crowd is unbelievable tonight.
Oh, they're emotional. They're packed. They're jammed. You can't find an empty seat.
Makes the front end of the 1-1. He can't get one to fall.
Timeout on the floor. It's a close one. The trigger fingers are getting itchy, baby. This one's too close to call.
Be a change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
That makes it a two-point game, Dick.
And the palms are starting to sweat, believe me.
In the post. Looking for a screen on top and got it. Well, let's see who will benefit the most out of that timeout, Dick.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
The live action we go.